ST segment and T wave represent ventricular repolarization. Main abnormalities of ST segment and T wave include ST elevation, ST depression, and T wave inversion. Since acute myocardial ischemia is one of the most important causes of ST-T wave abnormalities, displacement of ST segment and T wave changes are of fundamental importance. So, it is necessary for every healthcare provider to be familiar with causes of ST-T wave changes and differentiate myocardial ischemia from other benign causes. In general, all causes of ST-T wave changes are classified into two main categories: primary and secondary. Secondary ST-T wave changes occur when abnormal ventricular depolarization leads to abnormal ventricular repolarization. Abnormal ventricular depolarization is almost always manifested as wide or tall QRS complexes on surface electrocardiogram. Bundle branch block, WPW pattern, electrolyte disturbances, drug effect as in TCA toxicity, ventricular beat or ventricular rhythm, and pacemaker rhythm are well-known causes of wide QRS complex. Ventricular hypertrophy and hypertrophic cardiomyopathy are main causes of abnormally tall T wave that can develop secondary ST-T wave changes. Additionally, it must be noted that secondary ST-T changes are almost always discordant. This means that ST segment and T wave move in opposite direction of QRS complexes. So, negative QRS complex causes ST elevation and upright T wave, while positive QRS complex leads to ST depression or T-wave inversion. In summary, wide or tall QRS complexes can develop secondary ST-T wave changes, including ST depression, ST elevation, and T-wave inversion. This EKG demonstrates left bundle branch block. As you see, the complexes are wide owing to abnormal ventricular activation. There are discordant ST elevations in AVR and V1 to V4. Discordant ST depressions with T-wave inversions are present in lateral leads as well. As we explained, all these ST-T changes are due to wide QRS complexes. Next, EKG demonstrates WPW pattern. Thanks to delta wave, the complexes are wide, there are discordant ST elevations in V1 to V3 in AVR, discordant ST depressions are discernible in V4 to V6 and inferior leads as well. So, like previous strip, ST-T changes in this strip are because of wide complexes. Next, EKG demonstrates LVH. As we expect, there are discordant ST depressions in lateral leads due to underlying left ventricular hypertrophy. What about primary ST-T wave changes? Primary ST-T wave changes are caused by abnormal repolarization in absence of abnormal ventricular activation. According to this definition, any abnormal ST-T wave changes in presence of normal QRS complexes is called primary ST-T wave changes. It has several important differential diagnoses: acute ischemia, acute pericarditis, early repolarization, and electrolyte disturbances like hyperkalemia or hypercalcemia can cause primary ST elevations. On the other hand, any kind of tachycardia or tachyarrhythmia, drug effects including digoxin effect, and electrolyte disturbances like hypokalemia or hypocalcemia are main causes of primary ST depression. Medical history, laboratory, and other associated EKG findings help us differentiate them from each other. Remember that nonspecific ST-T wave changes is a common cause of primary ST-T wave changes as well. For more information about nonspecific ST-T changes, tap the link in right upper corner. In summary, morphology of QRS complexes is the key way to differentiating primary from secondary ST-T changes. Wide or tall QRS complexes with discordant ST-T changes favors secondary type, while any ST-T changes in presence of normal QRS complex is so-called primary type. Let's go through several examples. This EKG strip demonstrates supraventricular tachycardia. As you see, in spite of narrow QRS complexes, primary widespread ST depressions due to high cardiac rate is present. It must be noted that tachycardia of any cause can develop widespread STT changes due to transient subendocardial ischemia. This tracing demonstrates hypokalemia. There are diffuse ST depressions with prominent U waves and prolonged QT interval that favor severe hypokalemia. Our next EKG demonstrates benign early repolarization, or BER. Widespread ST elevations with concomitant fishhook sign and lack of reciprocal ST depression are highly in favor of early repolarization. As we said, one of the common causes of primary ST elevation is BER. The last strip demonstrates acute anterior ST elevation MI. There are obvious ST elevations in V1 to V4 with reciprocal ST depressions in inferior leads that highly favor acute ST elevation MI. We will thoroughly discuss primary STT changes elsewhere. Thanks for watching this video. If you are interested in learning more about EKG basics, subscribe me and ring the bell. Good luck!